And not to forget our salsa matcha. Not a lot. This stuff right here is fire. All right. There we go. All right, y'all. Hey everybody, Mike Chavez here once again. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. All right, today y'all, special treat. I've never done this dish before. I've done something similar to it. This is gonna be fried chicken quesadillas, okay? So we're gonna make up some masa harina. Today we're using yellow corn masa, okay? I'm gonna make some chicken tinga, which is basically a Mexican chicken taco filling, okay? With chipotles and onions and garlic. This is gonna be really good. So, we're gonna fill these quesadillas with some Monterey Jack cheese. We're gonna fry them. We're gonna put chicken tinga in there and some. I'm gonna make some Mexican chili oil, also known as salsa matcha. Very hot, very hot. So I'm gonna show you how I do that with D'Arbo chilies, which are hot, okay? So y'all stick around. This is gonna be really, really good. So once again, let's do it. All right. All right, y'all, we're gonna start this off making the chicken tinga. So for the chicken tinga, I have a little over 2 pounds of whole chicken thighs. I'm gonna bone these and skin these. Got some chicken stock, some diced tomatoes, onion, garlic, chipotles in adobo, and for our spice mix, I've got a little bit of brown sugar, a little bit of cinnamon, and some freshly ground cumin or cumino. All right, now I'm gonna probably put a little bit of MSG in there just for giggles. All right, I'll just show you one of these. So what we're gonna do is get the skin off. Pretty easy, we just pull the skin right off. All right, cut down your bone. Until we get down to the bone, you'll feel that bone. Kind of use your thumb, push down in there. Get on the side of the bone, on both sides. Up top, kind of get underneath it a little bit, get your fingers under there, pull this bone right out, kind of scrape it. All right, there we go. Bones out. There's a piece of cartilage left in here. Get that out. There we go. Boneless, skinless chicken breast, chicken thigh. All right, y'all, so we got all these thighs boned, skinned. Still a little bit of fat on there, but we're gonna leave that. Fat is flavor. So, if y'all interested, this knife I was using to do this is a Dexter boning knife. I have this listed in my Amazon store. There's a link in the description to my Amazon store. I try to put just about everything in there that I use in all of my cooking videos, including this Dexter knife. So these chicken thighs, they gotta be seasoned. So what are we gonna season them with? My go-to seasoning, of course, is Cosmo's SPG, salt, pepper, garlic. So we're gonna go ahead, season them up. salt, pepper, garlic. Not too heavy. All right, so we'll cut the root end off. Both halves. So the way, they just want you to slice this. So one of the best ways is go with the lines in the onion. Now we'll get to our garlic. I like to cut the little woody end off of the garlics. Give them a smash. All right, give them a chop. All right, here you go. This is a Lodge cast iron enamel pot. We're gonna preheat it a bit. Then I've got some avocado oil in my spray bottle. Now I got these spray bottles down in my Amazon store too. I love these spray bottles. If you've been watching my videos any length of time, these Evo spray bottles, you know, I've been using them for a long time and they work great. So I have avocado oil in this one, and I got this other one here that's got olive oil in it. Okay, this is the one, I've had this one probably 5 years. Works great. Helps you control your how much oil you put in your food. I love it. All right, got our cast iron pot preheated. So I'm going to take, this is avocado oil once again. Spray that in there. Probably half a teaspoon or so. Lay our chicken thighs in here. We're going to brown these up. Okay, you don't want to crowd them. Get our pieces. All right. All right. Get this chicken out of here. Got some nice fond in the bottom there. Put us a little more oil. Drop the onion. All right, get this onion cooking. Let this onion brown up a little bit. This is gonna take 15 minutes, 20 minutes, get this onion nice and brown. These onions are browned up some, more fond is formed in the bottom. So, put in our garlic. Give that a stir. And put in our cumin, cinnamon, and brown sugar. All right. So we'll cook this for a little bit. Let those spices bloom a bit. Got some more fond in the bottom of the pot. All right. Put in our tomatoes. So this is a 14.5 ounce can of diced tomatoes. Calls for about a half a cup of chicken stock. We'll put some chicken stock in there. If we need more later, we'll put more. All right. Turn our heat up a teeny bit. Scrape the bottom of the pot. Two tablespoons. That's about what's left in that jar there. About two tablespoons. So we'll put the rest of this chipotle, and this is, you don't have to buy this kind, you can get the kind that are whole and chop them up. I'm gonna get the rest of this chipotle out of this jar. So I'm gonna put a little bit of chicken broth in there. Give it a shake. All right. I'm gonna go ahead, put me about a little bit of MSG, just a flavor enhancer, not too much. About a quarter teaspoon. Just to wake it up. All right, let's make sure all the fond is scraped up off the bottom. All right, put the chicken back in. Make sure you get any juices, accumulated juices in there. Press it down in there. Let it come back to a simmer. We'll go ahead and put this heat on low. Put your tight lid on. We're gonna let that go about 15-20 minutes. We'll come back, we'll flip the chicken over after about 5 minutes, and then we'll go from there. All right. All right, y'all, this has been going for about 30 minutes. Let's see what we got. Get a piece of chicken out. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and put this on a tray. We'll let that cool a bit. We're gonna shred this chicken in a minute. But first, now the recipe says to put this in a blender, but I don't really feel like getting the blender out, so I'm going to use an immersion blender. So I got my immersion blender. I'm going to blend this until it's smooth. Put this back on the burner. We'll leave the burner off for a minute. Bring our chicken back. Taking two forks. Go ahead and shred this chicken. Chicken back in. Stir it up. I'm going to put my heat back on low. Put the lid back on. So we want this on low. I'll let that cook another 10-15 minutes. We'll put it to the back, then we'll get our masa together. Get ready. All right, today we're going to be making these with the yellow corn masa. Masa harina. A cup. We're only going to make a few of these. Put about half a teaspoon of salt in there. Get us a cup of hot water. All right, put about half of the water in there. Start mixing. Now, if you watch my last tortilla video, you know You want to get this just like with the tortillas. Not too much, not too little. Give us a ball. Squeeze, no cracks. Okay, so we're gonna let this hydrate for about 30 minutes and then we'll make our quesadillas. I'm gonna cover this with a damp towel. All right, now can't have quesadilla without cheese, so I got some Monterey Jack cheese. So I'm gonna shred me up a nice handful of this. All right, my cheese is shredded, so we'll set this to the side. All right, so I got a little skillet here with some peanut oil. We're gonna heat up. So I want to bring this up to temp before I make these quesadillas. Get this up to about 350 or so. All right, our oil is up to temp. So let's go ahead and get me some masa. So I want these balls for these quesadillas a little bit bigger than a golf ball. Between a golf ball and a tennis ball. Nice and big. So we'll set that down there. Remember, don't forget your plastic wrap. All right, now we're not gonna smash these down very thin at all. So, let's try this. So we'll get the wrap, plastic wrap off of that. Bring this over here. Put some queso on there, some cheese. All right, we'll fold them over. Pinch them off. This off here, lay this down in the oil, make another one. We'll lay another one down. There we go. All right. See what the bottom looks like. Light brown, there we go. Looking good. So we'll do these two at a time. I'm only gonna make about four of them. Go ahead and set them on a wire rack. All right. All right now. So we take our quesadillas, take a knife, cut them open. Along the edge. Look at that. cheese is nice and melted. So let's get, open it up. Get our tinga. Put some tinga on in there. There we go. So we'll go ahead, put a little shredded lettuce in there. A little salsa verde. And not to forget our salsa matcha. Not a lot. This stuff right here is fire. All right. There we go. All right, y'all. Let's try these out. All right, y'all, here we go. Fried quesadillas, Mexican style, with chicken tinga and some salsa matcha. So we fried these up, made the chicken tinga or the Mexican chicken taco meat, made up our fresh masa, put some cheese in there, folded them over, fried them up, opened them up, put the tinga, lettuce, salsa verde, and the salsa matcha. Y'all ready for this? Look at that. I'm ready for this. Taste! Oh my God. That's a mouthful right there, y'all. Mmm. Get on the tea. Look at that. There we go. One more. Taste! So it's the first time I ever made the quesadillas like that. Won't be the last. You can put anything you want in here, any kind of cheese, any kind of meat. That salsa matcha. Ooh, I feel it. Top of my head's tingling. That is really good. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave me a thumbs up. Questions, comments, leave them below. And check out some of these other videos over here. You won't be sorry you did. And for everything I use in my videos, just about everything, I've got an Amazon storefront. Link is below. Click on that to check out the products I use. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button right there, y'all. All right. Thanks for coming. We'll see y'all next time. Bye, everybody.